Hey, Game Squad, how you guys doing? Welcome back to my channel. So in case you're watching these back to back, yes, I'm recording two videos at one because hello, we're trying to save time. We don't have time to waste time because we got things to do, right? You have your goal list, right? You set your goals up. You don't have to have massive goals. It could be like really, really small goals. It could be daily goals, weekly goals. Just set yourself goals so you know what you're working towards. If you don't know what you're working towards, then you're just like spinning your wheels and you're not getting anywhere and you can't see that you're getting anywhere. Sometimes if you're just going and you don't stop to kind of assess what you've achieved or what you've done so far, you can feel like you've done nothing. So you really need to take a deep breath, relax, take a few minutes to yourself, recenter, and then analyze. Start thinking, okay, what did I do this week? What are some things I tackled on my to-do list? What are some things I did that got me closer to my goal? If you're sitting there and you realize you haven't done anything, that's a slight little problem. So that means you need to reevaluate what you're doing with your days and maybe think about doing to-do list, you know, making a big calendar. And so you can see that visual big calendar and you can do the check marks. Like, I know that's kind of like what kids do, you know, giving like a little tour board or something like that. But I mean, a lot of people are visual people and sometimes visually seeing stuff can really get it to focus and set into your mind. And then you can, you know, really attack your goals each day or each week or each month, however you want to do it. So also visual boards. I think I mentioned that before. Create a visual board. Create a board that has your goals, you know, that signify or symbolize what goal you have. And put it somewhere where you're going to see it every day. If it's in your bedroom, if it's in your bathroom, if it's right at your front door, that's a great thing. I say put it at your front door. Before you go out, look at it. Yep. It's happening today. And you step out. Always step out with your right foot so you can start your day off on the right foot. All right, guys, that's my little thoughts that I like to do at the beginning of the video. So let's go ahead and jump into why we're here. Well, we're here for that too. I'm trying to empower you guys, motivate you as well as motivate myself. So the second reason why we're here is a unit review, not on what I'm wearing, but I will include the link to that video so you can know who she is. Okay. Guys, it's the end of the night. So you know my personality is right there. It's fully downloaded. This is me. I'm out here. I'm silly. I'm goofy. That's just me. Okay, so I have another Bobby Boss unit that I have to review for you guys. New, fresh off the truck, hot off the press. I've been watching Bobby Boss Instagram, going on different websites, Google, trying to find this unit. So this is Miss Carmella, and this is MBLF 190. So this is she. And she's the 13x4 hand tied Swiss lace human hair blend. So Bobby Boss has been dropping a lot of these human hair blends. Remember, I already reviewed one, which was Shelby. Okay, Shelby was one, a new one that they had come out with, and there's some other ones, and Carmella was another one. I just said that. Okay, so it's ear to ear natural hairline, free parting, seamless finish, blends perfectly. So I feel like Bobby Boss might be trying to compete with Sensationnel. That's kind of what I'm getting, the vibe I'm getting from here. The only thing is they're 13x4, where Sensationnel is 13x6. So ear to ear, large lace, most natural hairline, parts in any direction, whoop-de-whoop-de-woo-de-woo. So, yeah, sorry, I was reading the back. And this is called their Designer Mix Human Hair Blend. So synthetic fiber with the best quality human hair, so which helps to amplify longevity, volume, and manageability. We'll see, Bobby. We'll see. So let me take her out and see what we're working with. She feels really soft, you guys. Okay, so let's take out that. Let's take off the stock card. Okay, I don't know why my chair is making noises. Just to let you know I'm not. Not passing gas. Okay, so in case anyone is interested, here's the stock card right here. And there's the back. So the model is wearing the TT4DX2216, which is a pretty, very pretty blonde. So it's out of the blonde family. I just didn't want to get blonde, but believe me, you know, some blonde units are probably coming. She comes in, your natural colors. And then she has some mixtures like the 1B/30, floor 30, this one, there's a burgundy color and there's three other blonde colors. So that TT4613A, that's going to be like a platinum blonde with dark roots. That's going to be pretty. Okay. So it doesn't say she has baby hairs, but there are some baby hairs on here. So if you can see those, she just has some baby hairs, but they don't advertise it, which is weird. You think they would have put that on there. Anyway, so there's that 13x4 parting space. Okay, so there's the lace. The combs are right on the sides of that parting space. One comb with the adjustable straps. I don't know, she didn't have that much give to her. So let me, like I always do, I'm going to undo the adjustable straps, cut the lace off, and then we'll see what she do. All right, guys, so this is Miss Carmella on. Ooh, I do like the color. Ooh, she party. She's a party color. Ooh, do you see these waves though? No, for real, do y'all see these waves? I feel glamorous. I feel like a glamorous mermaid with these waves. I say she's about 24, 26 inches. This hairline, not a fan, guys. Not a fan. It's like you put this, the time into this unit with 13x4, and then you just do this hairline. Like, why? Like, I don't understand. Okay, so let me show you the parting space. Like, how do you have bomb parting space, but then you do this old funky hairline? Like, I don't understand. I just don't get it. Like, I don't get it. I don't get it at all. I don't understand. And these knots, like, do y'all see the knots? Why are the knots black? Why? Why? I don't understand. Like, this is a gorgeous unit. It is so soft. Like, you saw the unit I just wore. Like, y'all put so much effort into that. It's pre-plugged. Why didn't they pre-plug this one? I just don't get it. For the price point, I know it's not human hair. It's still synthetic. But if you're going to charge this much, why not go in there and pre-pluck it? Okay, let me stop going on and on. Let me go ahead and try to finesse this. I'm just so disappointed. I would have thought they would have, I don't know. Okay, so this is her part down the middle for all my wig wearers or wig lovers who prefer a middle part. This is her down the middle. I haven't brushed her. I've just been finger combing her. So you can definitely, you know, run your brush or comb through her. I have changed my mind on her texture. I feel like she does have a little bit of yakiness to her. So I'd say she's like a silky yaki. Almost like a light yaki. Sorry, guys. As far as the luster, she has a little bit of shine to her, but it could come off as a natural luster. It's like a natural luster. The ring light, I think, is giving her more of a shine than she really has. I really like these layers in the front. I really do like that. So these are my natural baby hairs out. I didn't lay the baby hairs. And then of course you can do the flip over method if she'll work with you. So as you play with her, you are gonna encounter some snags. Okay, so this is her as a flip over. So I flipped her to the left. And then of course you can flip her to the right. So that's her flipped over to the right. Okay, and this is her as a side part, so you can part her to the side. You may need to train her a little bit and kind of use your flat iron to smooth her down and spray her with some hairspray so that she stays over this way. But ooh, I keep getting snags, guys. So, but she's cute like that. I do like that style. That's cute. I didn't tell you guys, sorry. She is big head friendly-ish. I mean, you know, she comes all the way right there. Let me look at both sides. I mean, she doesn't come all the way down to the side barns. She comes pretty far. She's definitely more big head friendly than that unit I just had on because she comes all the way to the edges.
I'm feeling myself. I want some hood girls looking back at it and a good girl in my tax bracket. Got a black card and less sex habit. These Chanel bags is a bad habit. I do balls, tail mavericks.
I will say that she doesn't move around. You know, even though she's not like big head friendly coming all the way to the, you know, to my baby hairs, I put her in that high ponytail and that bun, and I didn't even have to glue her down. Like, you just saw me move her. Like, that's crazy for me that I could do that with a unit and I have to adhere her down. Now, the baby hairs are right here. This is a baby hair. It's not mine. And it just, like, naturally curved right there. So, that's pretty cool. So, you don't have to use glue to lay the baby hairs down. They kind of just fall naturally. This side, not as naturally. There's some right that's some baby hair with my baby hair, but this side really fell naturally. But if you don't like that, you can, you know, always glue them down and you can do the, you know, have some fun with your baby hairs. It's up to you. That's the beauty of wearing wigs. You can do whatever you want, customize them to your liking. But I think I'm okay with the baby hairs not adhered down. I'm just not okay with these black knots. All right, guys, so my phone is definitely letting me know it's time to get off here because I ran out of memory. So, okay, sorry, I was checking to see if it cut me off. I don't know where I left off at, but anyway, I don't know if I said this, but if in case it did cut off, deeper skin tones, the black knots might not show up so drastic on your skin, but anyone who has a lighter complexion than myself, these black knots, they're just going to pop out. So you're going to have to wear her. You're going to have to cover up the knots with the hair. All right, guys, let me know what you think of Miss Carmela here. You know, do you think you'd still rock her? You know, like I said, do you have any tips on these black knots? If you do, please drop them down below. Let me know so that way I can do the flip over method. Hello, 13x4. All right, guys, if you're watching this and you're not subscribed to the channel, I don't know what's wrong with you. Get your life together and subscribe to the channel. I'm just joking. No, I'm not. Yes, I am. I'm joking. Subscribe to the channel. And then after you do that, you know, you hit that little button, that little bell, and you press that, and then you can get notifications on when a new video is headed your way. All right, guys, let me hop off of here and go edit these videos before bedtime. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye. Back, black magic, never left, but I'm back at it, and I'm feeling myself, Jack Rabbit, feeling myself, back
jack off, cause I'm feeling myself. Jack off, he be thinking about me when he works off. Wax off, that national anthem hats off. Then I curve that look like a bad horse. Let me get a number two with some Mac sauce. Or on the run tour with my mask off.
I'm feeling myself, I'm feeling myself, I'm feeling myself.